ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
Now let us continue with the same concept of racemos and inflorescence with the sessile flowers. Now all together we have discussed so far, the first one is nothing but the spike, then followed by the second one what we have discussed is catkin, or itself is called as an amentum, and the third one is referred as paddix inflorescence. Now we were in the fourth one, let us continue our discussion with head inflorescence. So we have completed all three categories, spike, catkin, spadix, and let's come back to head inflorescence. So take the head inflorescence, even it has a good concept to refer. Generally if you observe the flower, a flower has ray florets and disc florets. So anyway, so before that let me classify as usual as a simple head inflorescence. I says inflorescence, a symbol I here refers to inflorescence, and the second category under this is nothing but a compound head inflorescence. Compound head inflorescence. Now listen carefully this one. Now if you take in this case, we find what are called florets. Florets. A small flowers or small elongated pistils, or we find florets, small elongated florets. Generally in head inflorescence we find what are called as florets. How florets will be? They will be small and moreover they are elongated. Now these florets, now if you observe carefully in some of the flowers, they exist in the form of two types. Structurally they show variations. Let us take the first one as ray florets and other one as a disc florets. Based upon the shape and structure we call ray florets and disc florets. Now let us make clear differences here. Ray florets are female flowers. What is the symbol here? This symbol is for female, right? So better let me write female flowers. Moreover they show zygomorphic symmetry. What is the meaning of zygomorphic symmetry? It's nothing but we study about symmetry. Symmetry is nothing but arrangement of the structural organization of the body in case of living organisms. Itself is called symmetry. Now probably in zoology you studied about radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. Same thing when you apply the symmetry for plants, when you apply the symmetry for plants we classify into zygomorphic symmetry and actinomorphic symmetry. Let me give you exactly what is meant by the zygomorphic here. For example, you find ray floret structure will be like this. So for a flower you find what are called florets, reculus we call florets, right? Now whenever the floret is like this, this is called ray floret. So this mostly it contains the female flowers. Now what is meant by zygomorphic here? It can be divisible into two equal halves in only one plane of angle of division. Why do you call zygomorphic? Zygomorphic itself is nothing but what? Bilateral symmetry. I write here bilateral. In zoology we study radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. Did you remember? Bilateral. So for the same thing when you apply to the flower, it's called zygomorphic symmetry. What is zygomorphic? Bilateral symmetry. What is a bilateral symmetry here? A flower is divisible into two equal halves in only one plane of angle of division. So I'm just cutting this flower vertically, then you find two equal halves. In only in one direction you can cut the flower into two equal halves, and if you cut in any other direction you cannot make as two equal halves. So, whenever you can cut the flower in one direction into two equal halves, such type of symmetry is called bilateral symmetry. Now, for the flowers we call zygomorphic symmetry. Now, you look at the shape of this floret. How the shape here? The shape of the floret, if you look, it is like called as ligulate corolla. It's called ligulate corolla. Ligulate corolla means somewhat like a tongue shaped corolla. Now you can see this corolla is somewhat like a tongue shaped corolla. This is called as ligulate corolla. So such type of arrangement we find for what are called as ray florets. Then what about the disc florets here? Now disc florets, I'm keeping the star marks, very very important. Remember, ray florets are always the female flowers. Coming to disc florets, they are nothing but bisexual flowers. What's the meaning of bisexual flowers? We discussed for the last class. If the flower contain both stamens and pistils, both andrecium and gynecium, both stamens and carpels, such type of flowers are called as a bisexual flowers. But here, now it shows a symmetry. It's called actinomorphic symmetry. Earlier what we have written? Zygomorphic symmetry. Now what are we writing? Actinomorphic symmetry. Actinomorphic symmetry, in zoology you studied this as a radial symmetry. Right? In zoology you will be studying this as radial symmetry. What is meant by radial symmetry here? Now I am drawing the flower here. It is like a disc shaped one. Now you can see the florets, what you can see are disc shaped. What is meant by radial symmetry? You can cut the flower into two equal halves in any plane of angle of division. If I cut it in the crossway, I'll get two exact similar parts, exact parts. If I make it as crossway, diagonally, horizontally, vertically also, whatever the center passing the plane here, in whichever direction you cut it, it makes two equal halves. That such type of symmetry is called as what? Radial symmetry. So radial symmetry itself for a flower, it's called actinomorphic symmetry. See the differences. If you study as it is ray florets, if you study as it is disc florets, and if you forget the differences, there is no use. What we discuss are ray florets, you need to have the comparison with the disc florets. So here the shape is nothing but somewhat like a circular shape, or we say wheel shape, circular, or we call spherical shape. Right? Now let us look at the differences here. Florets are nothing but the small elongated part what you find in the flower. They are of two types. First one is ray florets, second one is disc florets. See the differences. Ray florets are generally, they are called female flowers, but coming to disc florets, they are bisexual flowers. Ray florets, they undergo zygomorphic symmetry, meaning bilateral symmetry. Coming to disc florets here, actinomorphic symmetry, nothing but what? Radial symmetry. And here the shape of the corolla is ligulate, somewhat like a tongue shaped corolla. Disc florets, as the name indicates, disc means what is the shape we find? A circular one, spherical one. So here we find a circular or spherical shape of corolla. So the florets are divided into ray florets and disc florets. Now when you keep so carefully the differences in your mind about ray florets and disc florets, now further simple head inflorescence is further divided into two categories. I'm just coming back to simple head inflorescence. What the two categories? Homogamous head inflorescence, heterogamous head inflorescence. So I'm just arising ray florets and disc florets. Keep it in your mind. Note down, write down the notes. Very, very important part. If you can remember ray florets and disc florets, then you can understand the further concept of classification, where simple head is divided into further more two types. Let us continue with that. We call that as homogamous and heterogamous. Now, keeping in the mind of ray florets and disc florets, let us divide them into two categories. So I'll write here, a simple head inflorescence is further divided into two types. Homogamous head inflorescence I4 in fluorescence. And the second category under this is heterogamous hedin fluorescence. Right, now let us look at these two categories. Now, as the name indicates here, homo means same. So here the flower with similar type of florets, flower with similar type of florets. What's the meaning of similar type of floret? Homogamous, homo means same. The total flower contains only one type of florets. All the florets are of same type. Then it is called as what? Homogamous hedin fluorescence. For example, in this case, let me take flower with only ray florets. So, I will write here flower with only ray florets means total flower contain only ray florets. All florets are of same ray florets called homogamous. Other one is maybe you find the flower with only disc florets. So, you can make very clear difference here. Either you find flower with only ray florets or you can find flower with only disc florets. Where do you find such type of arrangement? Let us talk about ray florets. Let me give you examples here. Examples are important for you, remember. Chrysanthemum. So, I am writing here chrysanthemum, tagetes. Coming to disc florets, the example is Vernonia. Vernonia, right. So, if you look at chrysanthemum, what is chrysanthemum? We say chamanti, right? Chrysanthemum, when you look at the flower, in chrysanthemum, what is the arrangement? It looks like this. It looks like this. All are nothing but florets. All are ray florets. Only one type. Total flower contains only ray florets. Example, chrysanthemum, even in tagetes. What is tagetes? Marigold. So, in that you find ray florets. Coming to flower with only disc florets means Vernonia. In Vernonia you find the arrangement is disc shape like this. Total flower contains only ray florets or total flower contains only disc florets. Only one type of floret, similar type of florets, it's called as homogamous hedin fluorescence. Coming to heterogamous hedin fluorescence, what's the meaning of this? So, let me give you here the flower with two types of florets. Flower with two types of florets means one single flower contain both ray florets as well as disc florets. The best example for understanding heterogamous is nothing but helianthus. Guys, what is a common name for helianthus? Earlier classes we discussed, helianthus is a scientific name for what? Sunflower. Sunflower is a common name and scientifically sunflower is called helianthus, right? And apart from this, even you find tridax. Tridax, these two examples you have to remember. Now, in this case, if you look at heterogamous means here, flower with the two types of florets. Now, if you see the arrangement, center sunflower, most commonly if you look at the sunflower, center you find disc florets like this. Carefully if you can observe sunflower, peripheral you find ray florets. That means both type of florets are present. So, I am writing here ray florets are present at the periphery, means towards an outer side. And if you observe carefully in the center we find disc florets. Disc florets are present exactly in the center. Now, one flower has the arrangement of both ray florets as well as disc florets. Both are present in the same flower. Such type of arrangement is called heterogamous hedin fluorescence. Right? Let me give you once again the clarity here. Hedin fluorescence has florets. They may be ray florets or disc florets. Now, based upon the floret arrangement, hedin fluorescence, and especially we are discussing simple hedin fluorescence, that's been divided into two categories. What are they? Homogamous head inflorescence and heterogamous head inflorescence. Now, if you take the homogamous head inflorescence, what's the meaning of this? A flower with similar type of florets. That means flower with either you find only ray florets or flower with you find only disc florets. Where you find flower with only ray florets? Chrysanthemum tagetes. Now, flower with only disc florets means you find in case of Vernonia. So, for examples, make sure that you keep star mark. Heterogamous head inflorescence is nothing but flower with two types of florets. That means helianthus, for example, if you look at, commonly called sunflower. Another example is tridax. What is the arrangement you find at the periphery? Outer side, if you carefully observe, you find ray florets. But if you look carefully in the center, we find what are called disc florets. Such type of categories we'll be discussing under simple head inflorescence. Now, coming to compound head inflorescence, we find same categories, but what is the difference here? We say in this case the peduncle is branched. When peduncle is unbranched, it is called simple head inflorescence. The difference is here, in case of simple, peduncle is unbranched. Peduncle is unbranched, important. Coming to compound head inflorescence, peduncle is branched. That is the only difference between simple inflorescence and compound inflorescence. Let me give you example for compound head inflorescence. Remember, Echinops. What is this? Echinops. Rest all is the same story. Rest all is nothing but the same story. Simple head inflorescence also divided into homo, hetero. Compound head inflorescence also divided into homo and hetero. But the difference is, in simple head inflorescence, peduncle is unbranched. Most commonly in most of the flowers you find simple head inflorescence. Coming to compound head inflorescence, it's very, very rare cases. What you find, because peduncle is branched, and where do you find such rare arrangement? Remember the example, Echinops. So these all four categories, we are discussing the fourth one. All four categories will come under racemose inflorescence with sessile flowers. Right? Let's continue further. Let us continue with the second category, that is nothing but cymose inflorescence. What is the first category we have completed our discussion? It's nothing but a racemose inflorescence. Altogether, how many categories do we have? As we discussed, we have three categories: racemose inflorescence, cymose inflorescence, and third category is called as special type of inflorescence. Now, where are we exactly here? Racemose inflorescence we completed. Now, we are in the second category of discussion, that is nothing but what? Cymose inflorescence. After cymose inflorescence, we need to continue further with the discussion about called as a special type of inflorescence. So, let us continue with cymose inflorescence. Now, when we make the clear difference between a racemose inflorescence and cymose inflorescence. Now, look at, based on the diagram, try to understand here. Now, this is racemose inflorescence. What we have discussed in racemose inflorescence here, no terminal flower. When there is no terminal flower, we discuss that peduncle grows indefinitely. Peduncle grows indefinitely. Why? Because terminal tip is not having a flower. Peduncle undergoes cell division throughout the lifespan and growth occurs throughout the plant, throughout the lifespan of the plant. So the moment when racemose inflorescence is given in the question, what is the basic character you have to remember? The no terminal flower and peduncle grows indefinitely. And what is the arrangement here? Acropetal. Opening of the flowers, if you look at opening of the F for flower, that is from base to apex. So these are the basic characteristics you need to remember about racemose inflorescence. Now with these characters, let us differentiate the second category called cymose inflorescence. Now in cymose inflorescence, I am writing down to you. Now look at the differences. Here also I am drawing the flower. But look at the terminal tip, especially the difference occurs with the terminal tip. Here we find what is called a terminal flower. Here what do we find? A terminal flower. So where exactly is the difference? So guys, blindly you try to remember, racemose inflorescence means no terminal flower, but the cymose inflorescence means it is with terminal flower. And moreover, here the arrangement, especially the arrangement, if you look at the arrangement, I am drawing in the diagram itself. Carefully observe the diagram in the structural wise when we draw the diagram here. Look at the diagram arrangement here. Now in this case, what we find here, bigger flowers are on the apex. Now if you come down, smaller flowers or the young flowers are at the base. So I write here, older flowers or first formed flowers exist at the apex. Young flowers or the later formed flowers exist at the base. So what do you call such type of arrangement? So here the arrangement is called basipetal. Basipetal. Now if you take opening of the flowers, F means flowers, opening of the flowers occurs from where to where? Apex to base. It occurs from apex to base. Now in case of racemose inflorescence, this is said to be acropetal. Look at the difference. In case of racemose inflorescence, this is acropetal. Coming to cymose inflorescence, this is basipetal. In some cases, in some members of cymose inflorescence, even we find what is called centrifugal arrangement. Centrifugal arrangement. In centrifugal arrangement, the opening of the flowers, F says here flowers, the opening of the flowers is from center to periphery. So guys, we have discussed very clearly these categories in the last class. Let us apply that category here. Now where are the exact differences? Look for racemose inflorescence carefully, revise all the points in your young mind and make sure that you come back to cymose inflorescence and see all the points. But let us quickly look for differences. Now let us make out differences here. Racemose inflorescence, no terminal flower. Coming to cymose inflorescence, having a terminal flower. If there is a terminal flower, what happens? Peduncle is definite. Peduncle growth is definite. Why definite? Once the flower formation takes place, growth stops. Once flower formation takes place, growth stops. Peduncle growth is limited. Definite meaning peduncle growth is limited. Coming to racemose, no terminal flower, the peduncle can grow throughout the lifespan. So peduncle grows indefinitely. So I hope you can make the clear differences here. Otherwise, I'll write once again very clearly. Just make a note of it. Racemose inflorescence and cymose inflorescence. So make out the differences here. No terminal flower. What do you write for cymose inflorescence? Yes, it has a terminal flower. Very, very important. So what do we write here? As this no terminal flower, second point, peduncle grows indefinitely. So underline the differences. Here, let us underline indefinitely. Means peduncle grows throughout their lifespan. Coming to this, here, peduncle grows definite. Peduncle growth is limited. So better you write down definite. Here it is indefinite and here it is definite. Now, apart from this, what is the arrangement here? Acropetal. Here the arrangement is acropetal. Coming to this part, it is basipetal or sometimes centrifugal. Coming to racemose inflorescence, centripetal. See the differences here. Racemose inflorescence is acropetal, cymose inflorescence is basipetal. Coming to racemose inflorescence is centripetal, but here it is centrifugal. There's a lot of difference, right? Now, these are the differences what we find between racemose inflorescence and cymose inflorescence. Differences are very, very important. Here, peduncle can grow throughout their lifespan. But here, in this case, so I'm drawing the diagram. Older flowers are at the base, young flowers are at the apex. And peduncle grows throughout the lifespan. In this case, I'm drawing the diagram here. Peduncle is limited. Peduncle shows limited growth. Older flowers are at the apex. That is, bigger flowers I'm drawing at the tip. And as I come down, I'm drawing only the young small flowers. So these two diagrams tells you the differences between racemose inflorescence and cymose inflorescence. Differences are very, very, very important. Now, let us continue with the types of cymose inflorescence. Practice along with the diagram so that you can remember so easily. Very easy points, this all you can remember very easily. But the thing is, you need to have a clear idea about differences. Then only you can understanding the meaning of the questions. Now, continue with types of inflorescence. We are in a discussion about cymose, so let us take it granted. Types of cymose inflorescence. Let us take types of cymose inflorescence. Under this, the first category is called as solitary cyme. The first category itself is called as solitary cyme. What is meant by a solitary cyme? Now, it is referred as a single flowered inflorescence. Single flowered inflorescence itself is referred as solitary cyme. What do we say? A solitary cyme is nothing but a single flowered inflorescence. We find only one flower. So if you look at that here, the position of the flower, if you look at axillary solitary cyme, we find one category, and other category is a terminal solitary cyme. A terminal solitary cyme. What is the difference between axillary and terminal? Simple, the positions vary. Here axillary bud, the flower is in the axillary position. Coming to this, the flower is present in the terminal position. The best example to understand axillary solitary cyme, just make a note of it. Examples are very, very important. Here we find hibiscus. Coming to terminal solitary cyme, here we find example datura. Now look at the flower positions here. Suppose if you take, this is a plant. So from where the leaf arises, it's called, this is axillary bud. Now in this case, a single flower formation occurs. So here you can draw hibiscus. Okay, this may not look like hibiscus, but this is hibiscus, take it grand. Now this is an axillary bud. Now flower position is axillary. So whenever single flower formation occurs, one flower formed from axillary bud, then what do you call this? This is called as axillary solitary cyme. Nothing, simple we say axillary in position. From where the flower is arising here? Axillary bud. So it's called axillary solitary cyme. Remember the best example, hibiscus. So why we say this come under solitary cyme? What's the meaning of solitary cyme here? Every time there is a formation of only one flower, and that exists from axillary bud. So we call the first category as axillary solitary cyme. Coming to second category, that is terminal. Look at the diagram. So here leaves are there. This is the terminal bud. Now from here you can see the formation of the flower. So this is terminal bud. On the terminal bud, now you can see a single flower. So here I write one flower formed from terminal bud. Make a clear note of the definitions. What is axillary solitary cyme? Here is the definition. One flower formed from axillary bud. Example is hibiscus. What is the second category? Terminal solitary cyme. That means a single flower, one flower formed from terminal bud. Then that you find in case of datura. So that come under the first category called as solitary cyme. Then the second category, here I am just writing second one. Let us talk about second one, B. So here the second category is called simple cyme or cymule. Second category as simple cyme, or itself is referred as cymule. Guys, as we write the more number of categories, try to look for more number of differences. So here I write this as a three-flowered inflorescence. It is referred a three-flowered inflorescence. What is solitary cyme? Look for solitary cyme. A single-flowered inflorescence. Then what is simple cyme here? A three-flowered inflorescence. What is the difference? Here only single flower, but here you can see three flowers. So just in your notebook, just circle the difference and just keep the star mark. That makes you to remember well the difference between two categories. Here it's only one flower, but here you can see three flowers. Now what are the best examples? Let us take jasmine and bougainvillea. With very common example, what we find is case of jasmine. We all know it very well. In case of jasmine, if you observe at the terminal tip or on the branch, you can see formation of three flowers. Okay, now even if you look at on the branch, one flower is there, and that is being followed by the arrangement of three flowers. So here we find three flowers every time, and each time each branch will be formed with three flowers. When three flowers produce, such type of inflorescence is called simple cyme or cymule. Examples are very, very important, try to remember. Now so see again what we are discussing, the types of cymose inflorescence. I'll give you a quick revision here. Solitary cyme means a single flowered inflorescence. further divide into axillary solitary side. Example, hibiscus, one flower formed from axillary bud. Terminal solitary side we find in case of Datura, where a one flower formed from terminal bud. And the second category under this, simple cyme or cymule, it's referred as a three flowered inflorescence. Examples we find jasmine and bougainvillea. Now further we have some more categories. Let us discuss with cymos itself. These two are basic categories. Now based on the branches, cymose inflorescence further divide into different categories. Now what you have seen here, based upon number of flowers, here we say 1, here we say 3, right? Now further if you look at, based on, here I write, number of branches further classified into different categories. So here you can write heading, types of cymose inflorescence, types of cymose inflorescence based on number of branches, basically divide into three types. First one we call monocacial. Monocacial cymose inflorescence. And the second category is referred as a dicacial cymose inflorescence. Then a third category is referred it as polycacial cymose inflorescence. Polycacial cymose inflorescence. So here what we have to study, types of cymose inflorescence, here we just count the number of branches here. If there is a formation of one branch here, monocacial. Formation of two branches, it's called dicacial. Formation of many branches, it's called polycacial. So here I write, inflorescence with one flowered branch each time, one flowered branch develops each time. Each time there is a formation of only one branch with one flower. So here we can write one branch with one flower. Such type of arrangement is called as monocacial cymose inflorescence. As you know the name mono, only one. So inflorescence with one flowered branch develops at each time, it's called monocacial. So what is the simple meaning? One branch develops with one flower. Now this is further divided into two categories, further classified into two categories. What are the two categories? Now we call helicoid cyme and the other one is called as scorpioid cyme. Scorpioid, yes. What are the two further categories? Helicoid cyme and other one is called scorpioid cyme. What is helicoid cyme? Now look at the diagram carefully here. Now here this is the branch. Now you can see development of one branch with one flower. After some time, so here it develops one branch with one flower, develops helically, one branch with one flower develops helically. What's the meaning of this? Now this is a peduncle, one branch has developed with one flower After some time, what happens? Again, here you can see one branch develops with one flower. So here leaves like this. And again, after some time, only one branch develops with one flower. And again, this is how it develops and makes an helical round. See here. Every time you can see only one branch having one flower. After some time, you can see the arrangement is helical. Such type of helically formed one. What is the definition we all can write? One branch with one flower develops helically. Such type of structure is called as helicoidzyme. Where do you find such type of arrangement? Example. Example is very, very important. Hemilia. Guys, you have to remember all the plant examples. Where do you find this? We find in case of a hemilia. Coming to scorpioidzyme. What we find in case this here, now here I am writing one branch with one flower, writing up the definition, one branch develops, no doubt, as like Leo, one branch with one flower develops in zigzag manner. Now as we write the definition, now look at for the diagram. So here one branch develops each time and is only one flower, because both categories fall in monocacial. But look at the difference in the development. Here it is helical development, but here you can see zigzag development. That means look at the diagram carefully here. Now for example, this is a peduncle. Here we can see development of one branch with one flower. This is a flower. After some time, again only one branch develops, that grows up like this, vertically up, and then horizontally here, again vertically up and horizontally. So this is how it develops. Such type of arrangement, zigzag manner, vertically followed by horizontally. After some time, vertically with only one branch with one flower. After some time, horizontally one branch with one flower. So as the development is in zigzag manner, such type of arrangement is called as a scorpioidzyme. So scorpioidzyme you find in case of, examples are important. So we can write Solanum, Heliotrophium. I write very clearly the spelling here, just note down, Heliotropium. These are the two types of arrangements which we find in case of monocacial cymose inflorescence. What is mono? Only one branch. Repeat, monocacial cymose inflorescence means inflorescence with one flowered branch develops at each time, one branch with one flower. It's further divided into two categories. What are they? Helicoidzyme, and the second one is scorpioidzyme. What is helicoidzyme? One branch with one flower develops helically. Look at the diagram now. One branch, one flower. After some time, goes helically. And second one helically. So you can make one round. Here you can see helicoid arrangement. So that's why we call helically. That's why the type is called helicoidzyme. Example, hemilia. Practice the examples, very, very important. Coming to second category, scorpioidzyme. Look at here. Now say the definition. One branch with one flower develops in zigzag manner. That means one grows horizontally followed by vertically. Again horizontally and vertically. Every time you can see only one branch with one flower. After some time, if you wait and see, the arrangement is in a zigzag manner. Where do you find such type of arrangement? We find in case of Solanum as well as in case of Heliotropium. Trophium. How much time, sir?